Howdy, my gentle humans. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Diana Chu here at Slow Gaze. Yes, we're doing an exciting video for me. I've been doing a lot of declutters, a lot of detoxing and recalibrating my relationship with my bare face, especially through this pandemic. As I'm minimizing my collection, a lot of the stars and my like all-time favorites are popping out. I'm way more satisfied and fulfilled with what I have because I know that I've kept only the tried and true items in my collection, and I have quite a few goodies here that I wanted to celebrate not only Black History Month, but also Black-owned beauty in general, Black-founded beauty, women-founded beauty, Southeast Asian-founded beauty, Latinx-founded beauty. So I've put together my favorite makeup I've just pulled from my collection. Some of it is rather new. I just got some Danessa Myricks in the mail, and I have never tried her stuff before. She came out with her balm contour. Well, let's not get into it. I'm already too excited to talk about the products themselves. So let's get together, get cozy, and if you are new here, I am all about slowing down, gazing inwards, and taking another lens and another look at beauty, maybe than what is mainstream and popular here on YouTube. So if you're interested in that type of mindful content or a little bit more about conscious consumption, because I was at the other end being a non-conscious and very impulsive consumer, and this is my journey. If you want to join me here and see more of my uploads every week, every Wednesday at 11 a.m. CST, please subscribe. I would really love it if you did. And yeah, buy me a coffee if you like my content. I've linked that down below. But really, if you've liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. That really, really helps my little channel grow. Let's dive in. So this is the look that I put on today. I am going to walk you through all the products that I featured and the ones that maybe are offshoots or they're like bite-sized reviews hidden into this video. There are just little gems in here. So I also admit I haven't put on a full face of makeup like this. I'm wearing a lot more foundation slash concealer than I usually do. I also have, you know, full-on eye makeup and as many glittery pigments as I could fit onto my eyelids today, maybe four different lip products as well. So this may have been a little bit out of order. I'm gonna show you cut-ins of me applying the makeup. So if it's not quite in order or if there's a little incongruity with the continuation, please understand. We're going through a time warp. This little mirror, by the way, I wanted to shout it out because a lot of beauty YouTubers use mirrors, like hand mirrors, and it makes a lot of sense now that I've gotten into this realm. All of the products that you use, half the time they don't even have mirrors, so having one handy is great. But I also noticed that a lot of them either come from PR or kits from certain brands, and it's just another chance to, I guess, have product placement or have another shout out to a brand. It's like wearing loud logos on your clothes. Nothing wrong with that, but I tried to make the conscious decision of choosing a nondescript mirror that was made from a local Wisconsin artisan. I live in Milwaukee, and this is made out of all cherry and walnut, I think, wood or different types of inlays. I've linked it down below in a lot of my videos, but I'll do it again for this one. I think it was under $30 or around $30, and it's really sturdy, it's beautiful, and I just think of this as like my modern heirloom. All right, let's get into the makeup. So because Danessa Myricks is so new to my channel, I wanted to start with her products first, and they are no joke. They do not budge. I had a swatch on my hand of one of her Vision Flush blushes in the shade Bread and Butter, and I'll show you it in one moment here, but it won't all even go away. So that's what this pigment is looking like. But I did buy two of her Vision Flush. These are my two favorites so far. Her Tiara one is the one that I think is the most like a highlighter, like a very traditional highlighter in that, well, it's not traditional at all, actually, because it is so metallic, so foiled. It comes in a little doe foot applicator, and it makes your skin absolutely luminous without giving it a strange shine, without giving it an overcast. And you can see that it just gives me this otherworldly champagne-y smoothness. I don't think that a lot of highlighters are successful. They might highlight texture or they might settle in. And of course, this is the back of my hand, so don't trust a hand swatch. But on the top of my cheeks here and all on my rounded high points of my face, I have a really smooth appearance because of this tiara shade. I really like this, and I wanted to compare it to the RMS Master in Radiance pot. I've been using this because I've been getting more into clean beauty as well. And this is a very similar tone. You can see that it has that warmth to it. It's almost like a peachy champagne. And I really want my camera to focus on my arm and not my face. It does have a little less of that smoothing quality. It's more of a gilded, shiny look, and it does sink into the skin versus the Danessa Myricks, where that one seems to like sit on top of the skin, rise above it, transcend it, and then do the smoothing metallic almost tin foil look. Whereas the Master in Radiance from RMS, I know it's not a black owned beauty brand, but it is one that is women founded, women owned, and it is one that I just have in my collection. I thought it was a very similar product in that I would use them the same way as a base. And so I like this because of how thin it is, the smoothing. I think the luminosity stays even if I put makeup on top of it, and it doesn't budge. So I love that. The tones are very similar. The only thing I don't love about the Danessa Myricks one is the scent. There is a floral scent. It's a little bit almost old makeup scent, you know, a little bit like you buy a drugstore lipstick and it's reminiscent of your grandmother and just lipsticks in general. It has a little bit of that floral quality, which is not my favorite. I do smell it on my face. You know, these are meant to be used on not only your face, your lips, your cheeks. All right, so the Vision Flush, a hit. I think Tiara is one that is a great universal shade. I think you won't be disappointed by this. And the next one I wanted to mention was her Bread and Butter shade. I think Ballet Slippers gets a little bit more like press or a little bit more talked about here on YouTube. They do get a little messy. You can see that it's already pooling at the top of this wand, and the wand itself is extremely sharp. It's tapered, so you do get quite a nice amount of control. But this is a wonderful warm mauvey pink. It's like a petal pink. I think it's extremely flattering on all skin tones, if I can go so far as to say. And I wanted to show you what it looked like next to the Westman Atelier Chouchette, because that's another, this is a little bit warmer, but this is another blush that I've been really loving so far. And yeah, a lot more dusty, a little bit more apricot, that peachy hue that I love so much. But this one was a nice hit because when you blend it out, it gives a similar peachiness, but it's just very, very, very pigmented. You'll see that when I apply it, I put it on the back of my hand, pick it up with a brush. You can go straight in. I've done that a couple times already, and that works just as well. What this looks like next to the Fenty Gloss Balm Cream. This is in Fenty Glow. And I'll talk about this product in a second again. This has a lot more warmth to it. It's not as mauvey, it's not as true pink. So if you're looking for a true pink, I guess that's where the Ballet Slippers name comes from. I would highly recommend this, and it lasts all day. Watercolor quality to her products and how lightweight they feel, how they let your skin look like skin, and they just kind of tint whatever is underneath. So I think they're very universal. I would highly recommend this color as well. I usually don't tend towards the mauvier, pinker tones. I feel like I look a little bit too feminine for my own liking, or traditionally feminine. I feel too youthful, a little girly. It just doesn't fit with what I perceive myself as or what I'm trying to portray with my vibe. But I will say that leaning a little bit cooler has suited my skin tone better. I have olive skin tone and a lot of yellow overtones, and I'm learning a lot about those over and undertones and why maybe a cooler tone palette actually works with my skin better. The next product I wanted to talk about was the new Danessa Myricks Balm Contour. This is a new product for her, and I think it was a really great move because we've seen how the Fenty Beauty ones work, how well that has been going. She came out with those matchsticks. People thought they were a little too dry. You had to warm them up. They were nice to draw on, but you know, they were a little bit fiddly. And then Fenty came out with the flat pans of her cream-based contour, bronzer, and blush, and those were a hit. And I think it's because of the usability of this. And Danessa coming out with a product that looks a lot more mainstream and a lot more traditional, in that you have the pan of makeup, you can see your face in it, you can stick a brush in it. That already is a level up. Looking at these other products from her, they're all kind of in tubes. You have to squeeze them out. You have to be careful with how much you use. They have a steep learning curve, whereas this one, you almost can't go wrong. And I think people are more apt to understand how to use this and build it up into their routine. I really love that. And so this one I wanted to show you compared to a couple other things, if not just one other thing. This is in the shade one light. It is not too light. I was going back and forth because she showed the same model wearing one and two, and I was like, okay, I think I could wear either of them, but I wanted to go for a cooler contour look. And so this is the shade. It is really beautiful. It has a little bit of yellow undertone to it, and I think it's still cool, but still yellow. It doesn't lean orange, and I think that kind of solves the grayed out look. There's a lot of warmth in it, but it's also warm cool, if that makes sense. It's more yellow gray leaning than orange brown leaning. And it works pretty well on my skin tone. I think it looks like a natural bronzer contour, the Westman Atelier Biscuit. And I know these are not similar products at all, but I personally just happen to have them. And look how different that is. This is a like almost red purple gray. It's very cool toned. It's very cool leaning. It's supposed to look more like a shadow. This is creamier. It has an opacity to it. Whereas the Danessa Myricks, at least this first shade, the tones or the value of grayness and depth, like the shadow tone, is around the same. I would say neither is darker than the other, and yet they're just very different overtones and different textures. The Danessa Myricks one is truly a balm. It feels kind of waxy. It has a tack to it. It kind of like sticks to your fingers a little bit, and so when you do pick it up and put it on your face, it does retain that quality. It retains that almost moisture plumping, waxy, balmy feeling, and it doesn't flatten you out, which I really love. It doesn't just look like chalk or ash. The Westman Atelier one I like because it's creamier. It doesn't have the same luminosity, and you can sheer and blend them both out really, really well. But I think the Danessa is a little bit more, I guess, universal because I think it's translucent. I'll do more deep dives into these products later. Otherwise, this video is just going to be way too long, but I am really loving this. I wanted to compare it to the Salt New York. Her bronzers, her contours are really lovely, and also in a pan flavor. Highly recommend the number one. I was layering a couple of other cheek products that are not Black owned, but they are Southeast Asian owned. This is the Heaven's Glow Faded Clementine Blush / Highlighter. It's a very innovative baked product. I think that's one of the best M Cosmetics products, to be honest. I like it more than her serum blushes because it's easier to use. It gives you a very natural yet ethereal look, and it can't be compared to too much on the market, except I'll say like other tinted highlights similar to the Melt makeup ones. Melt Cosmetics ones are a lot more pigmented, they're a lot more out there, and you have to really know your artistry to know which ones to buy. So I think these were really a hit. I think the Faded Clementine one is a little bit more special because of that tone. I just love it so much. I also pulled out the Patrick Ta Four Face. Always love that it just says Four Face. Double Take Cream and Powder Blush in She's So LA. I also really like this Nudie Tawny tone, just to warm up the cheeks and start to build a little bit of that peachiness and warmth into my skin tone. Two of my favorite lip products ever. This is the Fenty Cream Balm. I am so, 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 so glad that they changed the flavor Thank you so much. I haven't returned to the original gloss bombs, the ones that have glitter and shimmer in them, because I just cannot stand that flavor too much. It's all right for a while, but then I'm half the tube in and it's just too overpowering. This one has a tarter candy fruit smell. I think they still call it peach vanilla, but one of you did comment down below and told me that they reformulated, and hark, they did. I'm so glad they did. I really love the viscosity of it. When I wear a gloss, I want it to be nourishing, but I also want it to feel like I'm wearing a gloss. I don't want it to disappear into my lips. I love to put it on my lips and then pat. I pat it around and I make it kind of melt in and let it warm up to my skin. So I really, really love this, almost as a flesh color, a lip color. It evens out all of the blue and purple brown around my lips, which are naturally pigmented as such, and it gives me just enough of a boost to look natural, and the shine is outrageous. I love it. Badass MF Kit Uma Beauty lip liner. Very similar to the Kylie Cosmetics Coconut, which is the one that I've been holding on to and using. I've been trying MAC lip liners, NYX lip liners, a lot of different ones, and finally Uma Beauty came through with this kit one. I've put quite a heavy swatch, but you can see just it can lean warm, it can lean peach, it can lean brown. Like, I think it works really well with my kind of browny purple looking lips. I think it takes that blue down, that purpley blue around my lips a little bit down. It like warms it up, color corrects a little bit. And so when I put this around my lips and I like to go straight into the corners, up and down, and then really up into my Cupid's bow, and then just leave the top of the Cupid's bow blank and leave the bottom of my lip a little bit blank and just give it that idea that's a little bit plumper, a little bit sharper, and to me it just looks a little bit more natural for my lips. My lips are not very wide, they're just kind of petite and they're just small, and so I like to make them a little bit taller when I can versus building them up in all directions, if that makes sense. So this was a really, really great win for me. I'm so glad to have found it. It's made in the Czech Republic. So you'll see me use quite a few different brushes. I have a Marc Jacobs one, a really old Kat Von D one, a Sephora 50 powder brush, a blending brush that's also from Sephora. This is probably one of my favorite brushes of all time. And then a Bare Minerals one, which was one that I tried to declutter. I still probably will get rid of it at some point, but it was just a clean one in my arsenal to help blend things out. I don't think you really ever need that many brushes for one look necessarily. I've linked them down below. Oh yes, and lest we forget, the new Merit one, which is now sold out because it's so, so good. I've linked those down below as well. It's their number one blending brush. Okay, for the fun part, palettes. These are my favorite palettes. Of course, the Pat McGrath Mothership ones. So this is the Divine Rose 2. This is the one that also comes in that special edition pink packaging. If you are so lucky to get your paws on it, it is absolutely stunning. I don't know how to use this all the time because, like I mentioned, the pink and peach story always gives me a little bit of a balk at it, to be honest. Even though it's really pretty in the pan and I think this works for a lot of different skin tones, I just personally don't know how to use these blossom, kind of rosy colors. Some of these are just stunning toppers. I do love this one as like a highlight, and this one really matches the eyeliner that I used, which is not Black owned, but it is by NARS, and that is the Mambo liner. That really matches really well, that nice burgundy color that just perks up and wakes up your complexion. And then of course this gorgeous trichrome shade, this dragonfly wing color. I don't know how to use it. Very honest with you, I could put it all over my lids, I just don't on a daily basis. I think you can find really beautiful purples in here that don't make you look too dead. I think this is great for a cool tone look or a cool tone complexion because they really do add the pops and the rosiness back into your cheeks. It just feels so springtime. It feels like you're on vacation. They're really sun-drenched colors, and there's nothing else to say. It's like whenever you open it up, it looks like a ray of sunshine just starts beaming out. And I'm glad that Mother Pat did come out with that pink, that rose gold pinky palette color, because to me, it suits this ethos a lot better. So the other one that I use, and it's not one that I dip into very often, but it is my favorite Pat McGrath palette of all time. If I had to choose one over and over again, it would be this one. I think it's her first Mothership one. It's made in Italy, like most of her products, and this is the blue slash taupe slash cool toned silver gray toned product with just pops of really great like solar light. I love this because there is a pretty nice neutral toned highlight that you can put all over your lids. We have a slightly warmer taupe. That's a nice transition for my skin tone. And then that warms everything up a little bit. And then you can cool everything down with these other shades that really bring the sultriness. And then of course, let's not forget the gorgeous blues. Those are unbeatable, simply unbeatable. This NYX palette tries to beat it a little bit, not really. If I couldn't afford the Pat McGrath ones, or if I didn't want to afford them again, this palette is one that I would buy over and over again as the only palette I need to own. And that's quite a statement. I don't see people talk about this enough. This is the Uma Beauty Black Magic palette. It is in their shade Poise. I know that Uma doesn't have like that many palettes on the market right now. There are some Carnival ones. There are some that are a little bit jazzier. They have greens and pinks and chartreuses, magentas. Like they're really vibrant and a lot of bold energy. But this one has a little bit more of a sultriness. That Poise name I think is pretty suitable. And yet it welcomes you with that warm tone, that sultry row that's cascading, like true earth vibes, Mother Earth vibes at the top. And then on this row, which I'm calling the bottom, but I'm just holding it upside down so the mirror doesn't blind you, this bottom row here is full of shimmers, except of this Omo shade here, which I use as my warm, kind of transition-y, buttery shade. These are also no joke. I love how they correspond to each other. You can kind of use these in quads as well. This magician shade, magical shade, is almost like a pressed glitter. It feels gritty to the touch, but it's still soft. And look at how bright that came out. I mean, Pat McGrath's shimmers are really unbeatable, but this Uma one I think is very wearable. It is not too yellow toned, it is not too silver toned, it's a true gold, and it is pretty magical. I think that gives a great pop to any of the shades and looks that you're using. So I used it on a damp smudge brush, the Marc Jacobs one, and I just popped it right under, and that just brightened everything up. Blue shade, the C Moha shade, is a true navy. And again, Pat McGrath's ones you just can't beat. Let me just swatch Pat's blue. See how they just can't compare to each other? And yet I think this one is far more wearable. This was made in Italy as well, so really high quality. I think this entire palette is nice and slim, but it's really high quality. You can see the foil, the soft touch, the mirror is nice and inset. It has like some affirmations, some positive affirmations here. The names are all nicely designed in. It just feels like a luxe palette to me without me feeling like it's too precious, because the Pat McGrath ones are too precious to me. They're almost like crown jewels, and I open it up and I expect to lay it down very carefully in a bed of roses and use it from there, whereas this one feels like I can beat it up a little bit and it'll still hold true. The only drawback that I have from this palette is it's not cool tone friendly that much. I wish that one of these two redder earth clay shades, the Mother and the Feminist, I wish one of them was like a taupier, brownish, deep color that isn't quite black, but has like an ashier gray tone to it, maybe a purple leaning, I don't know. Maybe just one step between these two and cool toned, and I think this palette would really sing for a lot more people. And you know, my skin tone is light medium, leaning closer to light, and I still find this really wearable and usable. So I'd be remiss to end this video without mentioning a few of my favorite Melt Cosmetics products, because even though this is a Black-owned beauty video, again, this brand was formulated by two Latinx sisters or friends, I think. I'll try to research more on them. Their pigments, if you have not tried their palettes, I used the She's in Parties palettes. This one to me is like a smaller subset. It's like one color story, whereas a lot of the other palettes they have are have like sections. One is a more neutral section, one is a more like true color section. They have a lot of different ideas and concepts coming out, and so I really appreciate that. They're not always beholden to just one, like the Urban Decay Naked palettes. You know, they always have just that one construction. Melt seems to mix it up a little bit. They have their smaller palettes, they have their larger palettes, they have Beetlejuice, they have like a lot of different things going on. Anyway, She's in Parties palette. I really wanted to go in with the Skeleton's Kiss. It has that warm peachiness, again, that I think works really well with this look. It's almost chalky and almost ethereal. Like, I think I could use it as a really successful highlight. Maybe you can't see it quite as strongly there, but it's giving me a really almost unnoticeable peachy glow, just a little bit of a creaminess that I put underneath my brow bones. I didn't use this Gemini palette, but I wanted to call it out because it's one of my favorites from Melt Cosmetics. I love their She's in Parties, Gemini, oh, and the Rust palette. That's my favorite of all time from them. And finally, the Melt Cosmetics 710 lipstick. This is very creamy. I think it's $19 US. So it's still in the luxury range. It's still expensive for a lipstick, but it is one of those really special tones. Burnt ochre pumpkin shade, very warm. It hits that perfect poopy like brown that works really well on my skin tone. And so I wanted to put that on my lips as the last layer of like oomph to tie in a lot of the strength from my eyes and give my lips just a little bit more presence. And so, my friends, this is where I will leave you. Thank you so much for watching this video. I am glad to get a little glam with you today and feel like I know how to put makeup on again. I'm really glad also to be celebrating some of my favorite makeup. Whether or not it's Black-owned or not, it's just nice to celebrate things that are true innovators on the market, things that inspire me to put more makeup on or use it in a different way to explore my own undertones and see how textures work on my face. All of this stuff is really inspiring. I'm hoping to come out with more videos of this nature. I want to ramp up more of this content just because I think my collection has been so focused on either decluttering, so minimizing, or looking into the clean beauty space, which is just not dominated by Black founded brands, unfortunately. The one that I saw came out, LYS or Love Yourself, on Sephora's website, that I think they purported is the first Black-owned clean beauty brand on Sephora's like clean list. A lot of the blushes are sold out. A lot of the things I wanted to try out are sold out, but that's okay. I'm not in a rush. Makeup at large, like this is the community at large to acknowledge that these are somewhat mutually exclusive at the moment, and I don't want it to be. Another shout out is to Tower 28. I do like their lip glosses quite a bit, but my favorite one is the Milky Jelly Shine On one in the color Oat. That one is like a true ballet slipper, like creamy milky pink, but it nourishes my lips a lot. I really love that. And then I've been using their No Shade Super Dew Balm just as like an eye under eye primer. It's very balmy. Works better as a moisturizer than it does as like a highlight. Yeah, let's continue this discussion and continue our quest to find makeup that works with our lifestyle and the things that inspire you. I hope you're feeling really cozy and inspired today. I will see you on my next video. Adios.